College students are moving home. It's myorganized.life live, April 20th, 2020. Well, there's another number things for 2020.
Yes, I didn't even realize that.
Why did those always stick out to me? I seem to always like...
You do. I don't know. That's one of your things.
Maybe I'm into numerology or something like that, you know?
Maybe.
I'm looking at patterns. I don't know. Other than it's the 20th of April. And this is my organized.life live. I'm John Hunt.
And I'm Leanne Thompson.
And this is a show where we give you organizing tips, advice, and another full week of shows. And today,
right,
we're going to talk about the migration.
The migration?
The migration? From people that are coming from college back home because all the colleges have shut down.
Right. Yes.
What do you do?
I don't know. Thankfully, I'm not in that situation, but you kind of are.
I do. But you know, it's interesting. Both of my daughters live in apartments and they decided not to move home.
Oh, okay. Friend
of mine, whose daughter lives in Austin, Texas, and she moved home 4 or 5 weeks ago because she just didn't, you know.
Yeah.
So this is all a big setup, okay? Because this Wednesday on our podcast, we have Perry Kirsch. Mm-hmm. And if you recall, just a few months ago, we were talking about empty nesters. She had sent her kids off to college.
Right now. Oh, they're back.
Guess what? They're back. Along with all of their stuff, too, which is kind of a challenge. So the podcast this Wednesday, we're going to talk about everyone's back home. Now what? So let's take a little look at this clip from Perry Kirsch.
The first thing that has just sort of been at the forefront of my mind is all of these college students that are coming back home and all the stuff they're bringing with them. So that's sort of what my battle that I'm fighting right now is that an entire dorm room of stuff showed up and it's covering an entire table and floor in my family room. So organizationally, what we're trying to do with all of that is kind of divide and conquer, looking at stuff that we'll just pack up that she will hopefully take back to school in the fall and pack that away neatly, make sure everything's clean. We've been washing a lot of linens and things and setting that stuff aside. And then what are the necessary things that she uses all the time that came home with her? And I've kind of let her set up her personal room here in the house, like her dorm room. I'm not a big fan of putting a whole bunch of holes in the wall, but I was like, go for it. Decorate away. Make this feel as cozy and comfortable as you would like to. So she can have a tiny, tiny bit of normalcy in what's otherwise a really crazy situation. So, I think that's the first thing organizationally we're kind of handling, just is dealing with that quantity of stuff.
Yeah, I think a lot of people, you know, thinking that maybe this is short term, whatever that means, 30 days, 3 months, 18 months, you know, who knows? But, you know, it's not exactly like you can declutter, but I guess you can declutter, right? And really think hard about what to keep and, you know, what you might need in a couple months. And I don't know, maybe there's going to be a run on those storage shelters too for people stockpiling their stuff for later.
Yeah, I mean, it's so funny. My Facebook feed and Instagram feed right now are full of people doing their own organizing projects. You know, they're just saying, "Wow, I have nothing else to do." You know, what do you do when your entire calendar just gets erased? So people have more time on their hands. You know, lots of people are juggling work and now they're having to kind of homeschool their kids and do all these other things. But we also just have a lot more time and we can't leave the house. So it does provide, I mean, it's not really, I'm not calling anything a silver lining right now, but it provides this opportunity to go through and do some decluttering projects in your own house.
All right. Well, you know, divide and conquer. I like that kind of analogy.
And setting up the your bedroom as your dorm room was very interesting.
Yeah. I mean, it's giving, you know, because I think that when you go in, did you ever live in a dorm?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yep. So when you go into a dorm, you kind of create your own personality there because all the dorms kind of look alike. So, you know, it's part of you. So going back home, you want to kind of relive that. Especially
I wonder if you can loft your like full or queen size bed.
Yeah. And get the mini fridge.
The mini fridge and the microwave. The Christmas lights hanging up.
Yeah. My 15-year-old Laura, you know, she wants a mini fridge in her room. It's like, why? You live here all the time. You know. She also wants an espresso machine too. So I mean
in her room.
Yes. interesting 15-year-old. So
that's
life. But anyway, yeah. So join us this Wednesday. Perry Kirsch, everybody's home. Now what? Yeah. We're going to talk a lot of tips about how to deal with that influx of furniture and people into your what was once that quiet, empty nester house. But yeah. I think a lot of people are feeling this too.
Right.
So anyway.
All right.
We'll be back then. We'll be back tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
We haven't talked about that yet, have we?
Yeah, we haven't talked about that. We'll find something for tomorrow for sure.
We'll find something, you know, because now that we're working remote, I'm sure you probably don't work on the show calendar as diligently as...
No. And well, we've been changing it up. You know, we've been on Mondays, we're doing a preview of Wednesday's show where normally we would flash back.
Right. I know. Just
episodes.
Times are changing.
They are.
So I guess you'll just have to find out what we're going to do tomorrow by coming back here 2 p.m. Central, 3 Eastern, noon Pacific, myorganized.life live.
The Organized Home Office from myorganized.life. When you work from home, your workspace doesn't have to be bland and boring. Brighten up your home office with organizing solutions from myorganized.life. It's just for you. MyOrganized.life. MyOrganized.life.